On either side the river lie long fields of barley and of rye that clothe the world and meet the sky, and through the field a road runs by to many town, Camelot. And up and down the people go, gazing where the lilies blow, round an island there below, the island of Shalott. Willows white and aspens shiver, little breezes dusk and quiver, through the stream that runs forever, by the island in the river, floating down to Camelot. Four gray walls and four gray towers overlook a space of flowers, and the silent island bowers the Lady of Shalott. But who hath seen her wave her hand, or at the casement seen her stand, or is she known in all the land, the Lady of Shalott? Only reapers reaping early in among the bearded barley hear a song that echoes cheerily from the river, winding clearly down to towered Camelot. And by the moon the reaper weary, piling sheaves in uplands airy, listening whispers, 'tis the fairy Lady of Shalott. There she weaves by night and day, no time hath she to sport and play, if she has heard a whisper say, a curse is on her if she stay to look down to Camelot. She knows not what the curse may be, and so she weaveth steadily, and little other care hath she, the Lady of Shalott. And moving through a mirror clear that hangs before her all the year, shadows of the world appear. There she sees the highway near, winding down to Camelot. And as the charmed web she whirls, she sees the surly village churls and red cloaks of the market girls pass onward from Shalott. And sometimes through the mirror blue, the knights come riding two and two. She hath no loyal knight and true, the Lady of Shalott. But in her web she still delights to weave the mirror's magic sights, for often through the silent nights of with plumes and lights and music went to Camelot. Or when the moon was overhead came two young lovers lately wed. I am half sick of shadows, said the Lady of Shalott. A bow shot from her bower eaves, he rode between the barley sheaves. The sun came dazzling through the leaves and flamed upon the brazen greaves of bold Sir Lancelot. And from his blazoned baldric slung a mighty silver bugle hung, and as his robe his armor rung beside remote Shalott. His broad clear brow in sunlight glowed, on burnished hooves his war horse trode, from underneath his helmet flowed, his coal black curls as on he rode the winding road to Camelot. From the bank beside the grass he flashed into her crystal glass, Tyrolay as he did pass, sang Sir Lancelot. She left the web, she left the loom, she made three paces through the room. She saw the water lily bloom, she saw his helmet and his plume. She looked down to Camelot. Out flew the weaving, floated wide, the mirror cracked from side to side. The curse is come upon me, cried the Lady of Shalott. Outside the isle a shallow boat, beneath a willow lay afloat, and round about the prow she wrote, the dim expanse with a glassy countenance, like some bold seer in a trance, with a steady stony glance, she looked down to Camelot. And at the closing of the day, she loosed the chain and down she lay. The broad stream bore her far away, the Lady of Shalott. Lying robed in snowy white, that loosely flew to left and right, the leaves upon her falling light, through the noises of the night, she floated down to Camelot. And as the boat had wound along the willowy hills and fields among, they heard her singing her last song, the Lady of Shalott. For ere she reached upon the tide, the first house by the waterside, singing in her song she died, the Lady of Shalott. Who is this, and what is here? And in the lighted palace near, there died the sounds of royal cheer, and they crossed themselves with fear, all the knights of Camelot. Out upon the wars they came, knight and burgher, lord and dame, and round the prow they read her name, the Lady of Shalott. But Lancelot mused a little space, he said, "She has a lovely face. God in his mercy lend her grace, the Lady